Hello and welcome to this workshop where I will demonstrate how you can knit these lovely egg cozies and also how to create these lovely tea cozies. After making the egg cozies, the tea cozies will not be a problem and you will find a short explanation at the end of this video as a bonus. In this tutorial, I'm going to demonstrate how to knit just one tube and make them in series if you like to. And you need a circular knitting machine with 22 or 20 needles. You can even use a smaller machine if you have one. It doesn't matter really, as long as it is a small circular knitting machine. You can use whatever small circular knitting machine you have and use the same pattern. So, it seems like a long video, but once you know how to create them, it will just take half an hour. So, you need a circular knitting machine. You need a color of yarn for the comb and the beak. You need, oh my, yarn. Whoops, yarn for the body. You need two colors of scrap yarn. I'm using black and gray for this project. I'm using black and gray, and it has to be contrasting to the rest for the workshop. I'm going to demonstrate. And a yarn needle, a pair of scissors. I'm using a crochet hook. I'm using a 5.5 millimeter crochet hook. You don't need to know how to crochet, but we use the hook to pull through yarn through loops. You don't need to know how to crochet, but to make it work, you need a crochet hook. I'm using 5.5 millimeter. I don't know, in your country, you have to find a convert list on Google. This is a European size. We are using millimeters. And optional, you can use safety eyes. But I will also explain, you can make them the same way I'm going to make the beak, with just my yarn needle. So, two colors for the chick. And two colors scrap yarn, a crochet hook, yarn needle, optional safety eyes. And of course, our fantastic circular knitting machine. So, heyo, let's go and enjoy this workshop. Knitting the pattern takes a few minutes, but we are changing yarn a lot because we are making just one long tube. No matter how many items you will knit, we are going to cast on with our scrap yarn the way we are used to cast on, zigzag, and then you are going to knit a few rows, at least five, but just knit a few rows. You will remove the scrap yarn later. This will not unravel because you casted it on. You cut the yarn long enough that it touches the table and put it to the inside between the last and the first needle on your machine. Then you take the next color of scrap yarn, put it to the inside long enough that it touches the table, put it into your feeder and you knit just one round. Make sure that you put it in the same spot between the last and the first needle and knit one round. Every needle has to catch this yarn once. So you end between the last and the first needle. Put your yarn to the inside. Then you take your working yarn. Make it long to the inside because you need it to close your tube later. Put it to the inside and knit 15 rows. You put it to the inside between the last and the first needle. Make sure all the loops are around the tooth teeth where you changed color. And just speed up the video. It's only a few minutes work to knit the complete item. And when you have knitted your 15 rows,
This is your body part. You cut your yarn long. I don't know how long you need, but and put it to the inside between the last and the first needle. You need that long end to close your project. Then you take your scrap yarn, put it to the inside in the same spot between the last and the first needle and knit one round. So that every stitch, every needle catches once the yarn. Cut the scrap yarn and take the next color of scrap yarn. Always between the last and the first needle. Put your scrap yarn into your feeder long enough that it touches the table. And then you are going to knit a couple of rounds, at least five. I will speed up the video. This is the scrap yarn that divides the two elements of your project. Just knit a few rounds, maybe for the first time knit a few more, and when you are done, cut your yarn long enough that it touches the table and put it to the inside between the last and the first needle. To start the next element, we have to knit one row of scrap yarn in a different color. So you always knit one row before and after your working yarn with the scrap yarn. Put it to the inside between the last and the first needle and take the color of your comb. In my case it's red. Make it also weer a long piece of yarn to put to the inside because you need it to finish the project, and put it between the last and the first needle, always in the same spot, into the machine. All those ends are in the same spot. And then you have to knit four rows with the color of your comb. Always watch out at the color change part. And when you are done, cut the color long enough that it touches the table and put it to the inside between the last and the first needle. And then change to your body color. In my case, it's yellow. And it felt on the ground, so I have to pick it up. Make sure the tail touches the table. Put it between the last and the first needle. And knit 25 rows or rounds. I will speed up the video. It only takes a few seconds. It's very nice to look at. I never clamped my machine, I just move the crank and hold the machine while tensioning the yarn. When you are done, put your complete ball of yarn into the inside or cut it long enough so you can finish it with that end. Put it between the last and the first needle. Then take your scrap yarn, put it to the inside between the last and the first needle long enough that it touches the table and knit one row or one round. Every needle has to grab that yarn once. Put it to the inside between the last and the first needle long enough that it touches the table. Then change to the next color of scrap yarn and knit the last piece of your project. At least 5 rows, but when you're doing it for the first time, knit about 10 rows. And then cut your yarn. And keep on knitting until your work falls from your machine. Now I'm knitting without the yarn. It takes two rounds. You have to help the last stitches to release them. Yes, there they are. And this is your complete project knitted in just one tube. I will demonstrate how to knit them in series. For this example, I have knitted just the first project and I have finished my project the same way I just demonstrated, but it's still on the machine. I cut my yarn and I'm going to put it to the inside between the last and the first needle, just the same way we did all the way. We take the second piece of scrap yarn and we knit one row. This is the piece we are going to use to separate the parts. This is the only thing you have to do to make it in series. And then you are going to start over the first project. Dus you start with the 5 rows of scrap yarn and knit the whole piece. And to start another one, you just put one piece of yarn, scrap yarn, between scrap yarn and scrap yarn. That's it. You put one piece of scrap yarn, one row between the last and the first scrap yarn of two projects. So I'm going to knit this very quick, so I will demonstrate how to separate them. So I've knitted my scrap yarn piece and now I'm going to knit the just one row piece of scrap yarn that I need to separate the scrap yarn from my project. And then I continue knitting with the project color and continue knitting in series with the use of just one extra row per project. So I'm going to make a purple version. I'm making a series of 2, but you can make a series of 200 if you like. And I see you back when I'm done with knitting. I'm almost done with my series. This is a series of 2, but it doesn't matter how long it is. And I just finish off as I did with just one. See? It's in series now. And now I'm going to demonstrate how to separate. Go to the one row of scrap yarn between the two pieces of scrap yarn that are at the beginning and the finishing of your project. Find the middle stitch that's opposite of the yarn ends and pull it out, and your tube, your projects are separated. Something is wrong. One moment. Oh, I have to. It's upside down. So you can knit in series. And now I'm going to show you how you can make your egg warmer from this tube. We begin with finishing off at the end. So you can see it's the long piece of where the stitches are loose. Don't pull at that scrap yarn, but fold your tube inside out like this and pull out the pieces of yarn that belong to the end of your tube, the scrap yarn and the working yarn pieces. And then we are going to look at the stitches we need to close. My yellow stitches are secured by the black yarn and you can see them in between the black and the gray stitches. You see, in the middle there are the yellow stitches, and those yellow loops are the loops we need to close. We have to find our first stitches, our first pair of stitches, and for that we use our scrap yarn. The black one is the one we use. When you pull at the 3 tails, you see in the middle is the working yarn, and that goes to the last knitted stitch. And the second piece of scrap yarn, see, this is the last knitted stitch, the tail of my working yarn, and this is the second tail of the scrap yarn, and that goes through the first knitted stitch. With your crochet hook, you go from the outside to the inside through that loop, and then do the last knitted loop. And that's your first pair of stitches. Then you take your working yarn, it's the same color. And with the crochet hook, you pull the yarn through both loops. And that's the first pair you have closed. You can see all those stitches and they are opposite to each other. So it's easy to collect the pairs. The stitches are just next to each other. You pick up the next two loops that are opposite to each other. You have three loops on the hook. And then you pull through the yarn with the hook. So pick up the two loops. You have three loops on the hook. Pull through the yarn with your hook. Through all three loops. And do that all the way. It depends on the machine you used, but you have to close as many pairs as have the amount of stitches of your machine. So for a machine with 22 stitches, you need to close 11 pairs. You always finish with a pair and then you pull through the yarn again and then you are finished. Then you take that one string scrap yarn at the same side as where you ended with your working yarn. Here is where I ended with my working yarn. On that side, I pull out that one string of yarn. And that way I can remove all the scrap yarn. Leave the tail of the working yarn. You need it later to finish your project. Okay, now we are going to close the point where the red part ends. But first I have to knot the two tails of the color change of my project. Not the scrap yarn. You never have to knot that because that's not part of your project. Okay. It's knotted. And now I will find the top stitches of my red part that's connected with the scrap yarn. So I'm going to make sure that they are nice lined up to each other. This is the opposite side of the knitting. And the stitches are a little bit different, the first and the last stitch. We are going to look at the red stitches in this project. Everything is lined up. And you will see the red stitches between the black and the gray ones. Now, those stitches we are going to connect to each other. You have to find the last and the first knitted stitch. You have to find it by pulling at your scrap yarn. You see, here's the last knitted stitch because the yarn goes through there. And then you will find the next stitch. That's the first knitted stitch. It's the opposite of the other side because we turned our work upside down. When you find those two first stitches, you continue doing exactly the same by connecting that first pair and then connect all those other pairs. When you make a mistake, that's always possible, you can pull out until you are where we just started and start over. You always have pairs. So when you end up with just one stitch, you have to start over with closing. Dus you can easily unravel this part and start over closing. As long as you keep the scrap yarn on, you can unravel and start over. So they are closed. I'm pulling my yarn through the loop. And now I can remove my scrap yarn. I'm going to remove it at the point where I just stopped, pull out, and now I can split my project tube. The first tube is ready for the next step. Leave the tails on because we need them. And then we repeat what we did. We are going to close the two ends of this part. And it's exactly the same as we did before. So you are going to find those two first pairs of those two first stitches. And you are going to join them with the use of the tail of your working yarn. That's why you have to leave a long tail. Don't cut the tail until I do, because we need them to join the project. This is exactly the same as the other part. Just connecting the pairs. And don't miss the last one. Remove that one string of scrap yarn. And then we only have the last end to close. We're looking. There's a stitch. There's a little trick. The working yarn is always between the two stitches you have to close as first. So that's a simple reminder. Then you're sure that you have the correct stitches. And now both our parts are finished. I'm removing the last scrap yarn part. You can reuse it over and over, so that's not a problem. And now my two pieces are ready for the next step. So let's continue. Another color, because I finished the yellow one without putting the video on. So first I start with the red piece of yarn, sticking it to the inside and let it come out somewhere else. That's just finishing off this yarn end. Pull it through the red knitting and you can cut it. And keep it, because you need it to make the beak of the chicken. Now we are going to join those two pieces to each other. And I'm going to use the yarn tail at the bottom. Now do exactly the same as I do. You are going to join it to the corner where there is no yarn tail, because we need it for the opposite side. Stick your needle through that corner where there is no yarn tail to connect those two pieces to each other. And now we are going to follow these straight tracks with V's. Look, when I put my needle under it, you will see those vertical bars, and they are hidden under the straight line with V's. It's like a rail track. They are on both sides of the tubes, and we are going to connect those vertical bars, and I'm going to demonstrate to you how. Line them up next to each other. And then you are going to stick your needle in the first V under one vertical bar. Don't pull your yarn all the way. Then go to the opposite side. Stick your needle in the V under the vertical bar. In the first V under the vertical bar. Don't pull your yarn all the way. Then go back to the part next closest to you and stick your needle where the yarn came out under two bars. Follow the track, but stick your needle in the same hole where your yarn came out, and then at the opposite side the same. You go in where you came out, and you do that like this. Don't pull your yarn, because we do that later. That way you can look better what you are doing. So you go in where you came out, pick up two bars, and do that all the way until you reach the corner of the smallest part. Make sure you stick in the holes and not through the yarn. Try to get up as far as possible. And when you're done, you are going to stick your needle through that corner again. And now we are going to pull our yarn tail and close our work. Make sure that it closes nicely at the corner. Don't pull it too tight. And now your work looks like this. And we are going to close the opposite side the same way. Take the yarn tail at the bottom of the short side. Put it into your yarn needle. Take your work, fold it. Stick your needle through the corner where there is no tail. To connect those two pieces to each other. And then go into the first V and pick up one bar. That's just for the beginning, to let it go flawless. And one bar at the opposite. And then start joining two bars per side, all the way up till you cannot continue. And when you're done, pull the yarn and close this side. Make sure the tension is okay. Leave the needle on your yarn tail, because we are going to continue with that same piece of yarn. And we will close the neck with that piece of yarn by doing exactly the same as we did before, but we switch over to close this tube. We only close until the red piece, and we continue by going through the same hole we went before at the opposite side, and also through where we went before at this side, and then pick up those stitches 2x2 until you enter the red part. You can smuggle if you went wrong a little bit. You can smuggle, that's not a problem. Go under all vertical bars of that same color. And when you reach the last one, you just pull on your yarn to close this part of your egg warmer. Egg cozy. Egg cozy. Now I'm going to join this part to that, to the opposite side, by just sewing through both layers. And when you're done, you are going to make a knot in your yarn and finish this piece of yarn. Stick it between the layers and let it come out somewhere else and just simply cut it. And you can keep that yarn tail for making the tail of the egg warmer. So, clean up. You see this red piece of yarn? I'm going to put it in my needle and then stick it to the inside of the head. Let it come out in the middle and nobody will notice. Next step is to close the back of the cozy. And for that we take one of those two yarn tails here. And we are going to close the back. You can do that whatever way you like. I like to do it my way. I stick my needle through so that the both ends are connected. And now I'm going to connect the stitches to each other. So I'm looking for the V's. And you will see there are the V-stitches. I pick up a V-stitch on this side. And on the opposite side, I pick up V's that are upside down. So instead of the V, I look for the V that is upside down. And those V's and upside down V's, I'm going to connect to each other. Don't pull your yarn all the way through. We do that at the end. Take your time. There will be a last stitch at the corner. But continue as long as you can. And this is my last stitch. And now I'm going to pull the yarn. Ta-da! And it's closed. Very nice. I'm going to secure this yarn end with a little knot. And then I'm going to stick it between the layers and cut it and keep it for the tail of the chicken. There's one yarn tail left and we use that to close the little hole between the back and the neck of our chicken. Just stick your needle through both sides and your hole is closed and you only have to knot your yarn tail and secure it. And then you are ready for the next step. I stick my needle through the layers, between the layers, and I cut that yarn tail and keep it for the tail of my chicken. Next step is adding the eyes. You can use safety eyes. They are not safe, of course, but they are easy. You can also use buttons or you can make eyes the same way you make the beak. I will demonstrate that later. But now I am going to add the safety eyes. They are never safe on this kind of knitting. But since this is not a toy, I think it's okay to use them. It's just for the demonstration. Be aware they are not safe on knitting. I'm trying to get them a little bit even. And there they are. And then I take the red piece of yarn and I'm going to stick it from the inside to the place where I want the beak to be and let it come out. Make sure there is a tail on the outside. And now I'm going to make a, I don't know, I put my yarn around the needle about 10 times, a little bit loose. And then I push my needle through all those loops. Hold the loops between your fingers and wiggle the needle through the loops and pull the yarn through the loops. Be careful. Maybe you have to retry it. And then you get a little bit of this. It's, yeah. Loops around the yarn. Stick your needle into your work next to the stitch where you came out. Pull it to the inside. And your beak is finished. You have to knot those two tails on the inside. Don't knot them too tight, because then you will pull your beak to the inside. And cut those two tails, not too short. And there you are. There's the beak. Now we have to make the tail. Collect some strings of yarn, whatever color you like or have, scrap yarns, and make it into a bundle. And then fold the bundle into a loopy bundle that is going to be your tail. Take another piece of yarn to secure this bundle with loops. Do exactly as I do. When your bundle is secured, take your crochet hook and stick it through the inside to the outside where your tail is supposed to come. And then take one of those two yarn tails and pull it through your work to the inside, to the outside. Go back with your crochet hook and pull through the other end through another hole. And then you can knot those two tails on the inside together. And your tail is attached. Cut those two tails, not too short, not too long. And your chicken has a tail. And now you can cut off the loops. If you like, you can also keep them. And your chicken is finished. So, now I'm going to show you how you can make a tea cozy. The tea cozies are not very complicated and you can make them with all kinds of big machines, but you can also make them with your small machine by just knitting the same pattern twice and join two tubes into one. So even when you don't have a big machine, you can make the same project by making the pattern double and join them. The first version is the small version, and for that we have to knit this tube. It's almost the same as the egg cozy. You start with scrap yarn, don't forget that one string, and then you knit 10 rows with red yarn with a long cast on tail, then 50 rows in the color of your chicken, and 10 rows brown for the basket the chicken is in. You end with scrap yarn, and you start with scrap yarn, and then you knit your second piece with a long cast on tail, 10 rows with brown yarn with a long cast off tail, and you end with scrap yarn. And then you are going to separate those two tubes from each other. I have separated those two tubes from each other. I've worked away the red piece of yarn and kept the rest for the beak. And now I'm going to join it exactly the same way as you did with the little chicken. So it's exact the same. I'm going to join the two sides. I'm using the brown yarn, but you can use, of course, the yarn in the color you like. So I'm going to close them, and they are connected now. That was quick. So I've connected them, and now I have to close the chicken the same way as you did with the small one. You close the neck and the head. I close the neck, the head, and I added the eyes. And now I have to close the back the same way as we did with the egg cozy. I'm closing it. Now, I'm almost done. I only have to add the beak, and I only have to add the tail. The tea cozy for small teapots is finished. I added some stuffing into the neck so that it stays up. This version is for small teapots, and now I'm going to demonstrate to you how you make them for bigger teapots. This is the pattern for a bigger teapot. You're going to knit another tube. Start with scrap yarn, of course, scrap yarn with that one row, and then long tail cast on zigzag with red and knit 10 rows, and then you knit 50 rows in the color of your chicken and 10 rows brown for the basket she's in, and you end with scrap yarn the same as the one we did before. Then you start with scrap yarn and continue with 10 rows brown, and then you knit 60 rows in the color of your chicken, and then 10 rows brown, and you end with scrap yarn, and then you separate this tube into two. I've separated these tubes, and now I'm going to cut my red piece of yarn that I tucked away. And now I'm going to show you how you are going to make this one. You fold over this tube like this, and the long tube you make exactly as you did the last one. But this tube, you have to close these sides to each other. So make sure that those two brown ends are on each other. Line them up. Close them as you did everything in this workshop. Pull the yarn and secure that yarn tail. And stick it to the inside and cut it. when you have a small knitting machine, you make this part from two tubes. And when you have those two tubes, you continue what I'm doing now. Okay. Now we have to connect the two tubes to each other. We are going to do that from two sides up. You have to connect one piece of yarn extra to this side, but you are going to connect them both up and then close the neck as we did before. So simple is it. And then you have two different sizes tea cozies that you can use for different sizes teapots. It depends on yarn and stuff like that, if they fit or not. So knit and find a fitting teapot. This is the bigger tea cozy that fits a bigger teapot. And look at that. Isn't that nice? Along with those little chickies egg cozies. And there they are, the whole family. If you like my workshop, give me a thumb up and subscribe my channel if you want to see more free workshops. I say bye-bye with love from Holland. See you next time. Enjoy crafting.